This video covers both the IB standard level and higher level elements of Topic 7 Equilibrium. Please make use of the contents to skip or rewind. If the activation energy is low, the products are energetically favorable, then a reaction will go to completion. However, with many reactions, such as the Haber process, there is not a significant difference in the energetic stability of the products or reactants. As a result, the system will contain a certain concentration of products and a certain concentration of reactants. This is called equilibrium. It is important to note that the reaction never stops. Both the forward and the reverse reactions are continually working at the same rate. This is why we call it dynamic equilibrium. Chemical reactions for equilibrium must have the forward and reversed arrows written in. A reaction where all the components are in one state are called homogeneous. If there is more than one state, the reaction is called heterogeneous. It is essential to always write the states and balance your equations. The equilibrium constant Keq is written here as Kc, as we are using concentrations here. Kp is the Keq for partial pressures. We will also discuss other K values with different subscripts later. The general formula for the equilibrium constant is here. Products over reactants raised to the power of their stoichiometric coefficients. The size of the equilibrium constant determines the side of the reaction that is favored. If there is a factor of greater than 1000, we consider the reaction goes to completion to one side. The Chatelier's principle states that if you change conditions to an equilibrium reaction, the system will react to balance that change. This is an endothermic reaction, so heat is written on the left-hand side. If you increase heat, you are increasing the left-hand side, so the system moves to the right to compensate for this. The same occurs if you increase A or decrease pressure. Here we have a specific example. In figure 705, we see that the increase in chlorine on the right-hand side has caused an increase in phosphorus pentachloride on the left-hand side. The reaction eventually reaches equilibrium as seen on graph B. The final result is a slightly new higher level of chemicals except for phosphorus trichloride. In figure 707, we see an increase in temperature, which is on the left-hand side, causes an increase of products on the right-hand side. Again, the reaction eventually reaches equilibrium. Temperature is the only circumstance that changes the equilibrium constant, as it unequally makes endothermic reactions easier. This demonstration shows that increasing temperature does little to help reactions in the exothermic direction. As endothermic reactions have such a large activation energy, an increase in temperature has a significant effect. Here is a summary of how the equilibrium is affected by temperature. One other point to note is that a catalyst does not change the equilibrium constant. It lowers the activation energy so that the forward and reverse reactions are both increased, but the equilibrium itself is not changed. So in summary then, these are the changes that occur with equilibrium. The Haber process is a good summary of how equilibrium is useful in industry. In this process, the ammonia which is needed to make fertilizer and feed the world's population is created. Ammonia is constantly removed from the system by cooling and selectively condensing it out. This then pushes the reaction to go to completion. Because the forward reaction is being constantly pushed in this way, the use of the iron heterogeneous catalyst speeds up the process. As the reaction has 4 moles of gas to 2 moles of gas, the increase in pressure also pushes the reaction to the right. Maintaining high temperature and pressure is expensive, so most systems don't go too far above 200 atmospheres and 450 degrees Celsius. As the reaction is exothermic, heating will push the equilibrium in the reverse direction. This would cause a lower yield of product to be produced. but because the speed increased due to the catalyst, the rate of reaction increased also due to the higher temperature, and the recycling of leftover reactants, the balance is usually found to be around 450 degrees Celsius. At lower temperature, this would give a higher yield but a slower rate, making ammonia production slower. The high yield is not critical as the leftover reactants are recycled. Although mentioned in the syllabus, I have not yet seen a question on this. These relate to mathematical rules of multiplying powers and fractions. The equilibrium constant will be altered and used in many ways. One of these is the reaction quotient, Q. This is simply the same as the equilibrium constant, but for systems not at equilibrium. By comparing the equilibrium constant with the reaction quotient then, we can determine if a reaction is going to now move left or right. For example, if Q is greater than K, then the products must be higher than what they should be, and the reaction will move to make more reactants. Hence, the reaction will move to the left. As with all problems in chemistry, make sure you write out and balance the chemical reaction before you begin. Make sure you always write down the formula so that your values are clearly labeled so you can follow your working, which will prevent mistakes for longer problems and help the examiner give you marks. Another manipulation of the equilibrium constant is the solubility product constant Ksp, which will also come up in option A materials. This value is the equilibrium constant without the denominator. It can be used as a reference value to predict if a salt will dissolve or in a chemical reaction if a precipitate will form. Here is a fully worked problem. Please note that the working includes a balanced reaction, all labeling, formula units, and a sentence answer at the end. Rice diagrams will help you solve even the most difficult K problems and prevent you from making mistakes or skipping steps. R is the reaction stoichiometry, I is the initial concentration, C is the change in concentration, E is the equilibrium concentration. Filling in the table is a little like playing Sudoku. Once done, the equilibrium concentrations are substituted in to get a final equilibrium constant. This is a harder example of a K problem. To make the algebra easier, make sure you don't use fractions for X. This is the last of the harder K problems. Again, write X for the unknown. The trick for these problems is that because K is small, X will be small. If the effect of X is less than a factor of 1,000, we can ignore it.
Before, we talked about Q as forward and reverse. We can also talk about the reaction as positive or negative G, that is, if it is spontaneous or not. Equations have been derived in your data booklet relating G and K so that K can be determined from G. Here is an example problem.